I believe that academic research and empirical evidence create the best path to a sensible investment philosophy and to sensible decisions in general. The academic and empirical understanding of financial markets starts with the efficient market hypothesis. An efficient market is a market in which asset prices always fully reflect available information. The implications of market efficiency for investors are sweeping. If asset prices always fully reflect available information, there is only one way to profit: by taking a risk that has been priced into the market, which can be done cheaply with an index fund. If the market is not efficient, then it should be possible to profit by consistently selecting undervalued stocks and timing the market. I'm Ben Felix, portfolio manager at PWL Capital. In this episode of Common Sense Investing, I'm going to tell you why you should treat the market as efficient, even if it isn't. In an efficient market, active management, the process of selecting stocks and timing the market, is not able to consistently add value, and index funds are the most sensible approach to investing. This highlights the importance of market efficiency to any investor. If you believe that you can exploit market inefficiencies, you will take a dramatically different approach to investing than if you believe that markets are efficient. In an efficient market, there is no such thing as undervalued or overvalued. Prices are simply reflections of information and expectations at a point in time. The only way that prices will change is based on new information, which, by nature of new information, should be random. This random movement of prices renders the prediction-based security selection and market timing that constitute traditional active management completely useless. We cannot predict randomness. Some of the earliest tests of market efficiency conducted in the 1950s examined stock returns to see if they followed identifiable patterns or if they were random. Before this research had been done, the assumption of economists was that trends and patterns were present in stock returns. In 1953, Maurice Kendall used early computing power to examine time series of stock returns. His conclusion surprised everyone at the time. He concluded that, quote, "In series of prices which are observed at fairly close intervals, the random changes from one term to the next are so large as to swamp any systematic effect which may be present. The data behave almost like wandering series. In other words, there were no patterns. The stock returns were observed to be random." Tests for market efficiency have become more robust over time. But before we get into that evidence, I think that we need to cover the economic reasons that markets should be efficient in the first place. Financial markets are highly competitive. Buyers and sellers of securities are competing to execute trades at the best possible price for their own self-interest. Financial markets are also highly liquid. In a competitive and liquid market with lots of independent buyers and sellers, we would expect buyers, based on their information and preferences, to buy securities that they deem to be worth more than what they paid for them. On the other side of the trade, we expect the seller to believe that the cash that they receive from selling the security is worth more than the securities that they sold. As an aside, this is always a good question to ask yourself before you buy or sell a stock. Who is on the other side of the trade? What information do you have that they don't? Anyway, buyers and sellers ultimately converge on the price to execute a trade. This competition between self-interested and opposite views, buyers and sellers, in liquid markets is what makes prices reflect the expectations of all market participants. The price becomes a mechanism to aggregate dispersed bits of information about fundamental values and expectations from all market participants. Every market participant wants to be the one to profit by bringing new information to the market. The challenge is that any market participant with new information is unable to interact with the market in isolation. They cannot know about all of the new information that other market participants may be bringing to the market at the same time, and even beyond that, they do not know how other market participants are going to interpret their new information. The result of this interaction is a market that reflects information in prices, while also making it extremely challenging for anyone to profit consistently by identifying and trading on new information. Now, let's take a deeper look at the evidence of market efficiency. It should be noted at this point that Eugene Fama himself, the man credited with formalizing the idea of market efficiency, has never claimed that markets are perfectly efficient. Market efficiency is an ideal state that real markets can only approach. Understanding that we do not expect a perfectly efficient market, The big question is whether inefficiencies can be consistently exploited to profit after costs. As investors, this is all that matters. The efficient market hypothesis is not a law or a fact. It is a hypothesis. What do we do with the hypothesis? We test it. The most common and robust approach to testing market efficiency is the study of fund managers' ability to beat the market without taking on additional risk. Excess risk-adjusted returns, known as alpha, are the ultimate goal of an active manager. Keep in mind, in a perfectly efficient market, the only way to consistently generate higher returns is by taking more risk. An active manager or some other strategy consistently generating above-market returns without taking additional risk would violate market efficiency. Whether markets are perfectly efficient or not, the question that we as investors have to ask is whether market inefficiencies can occur predictably enough to be exploited by us after costs and considering the risk associated with attempting to do so. In strict scientific terms, the efficient market hypothesis is false. But in practice, it is true enough to be treated as true. In terms of understanding and approaching financial markets, the efficient market hypothesis is, by far, the strongest hypothesis that we have. Do you think the market is more efficient or inefficient? Tell me why in the comments. Thanks for watching. My name is Ben Felix of PWL Capital, and this is Common Sense Investing. If you enjoyed this video, please share it with someone who you think could benefit from the information. Don't forget, if you've run out of Common Sense Investing videos to watch, you can tune into weekly episodes of the Rational Reminder podcast wherever you get your podcasts.